And one, and two, and one, two, three. I'm happy to be a super soccer star. I'm happy to be a super soccer star.
They might be a little too young to join David Beckham's Miami squad, but you can't fault their enthusiasm.
Yeah, Martin!
Ah, Martin!
Martin, high five!
And in a city that's already home to some of the biggest names in sport, it's an indication of just how far football has come. And there's little doubt here that Beckham is about to take it further.
As you see, it's growing. The parents are interested because it's like a social sport and all that. But I think it's going to be a huge success. Beckham, bring all the people, bring the soccer to the United States. It's great, to Miami.
David Beckham's ambitions to launch his own U.S. team were never a secret. Part of his contract at LA Galaxy was an option to buy a franchise at a discounted rate. And Miami seems like the perfect choice, at least on paper. But if David Beckham and his fellow investors need a history lesson, they don't have to look too far. This stadium used to be the home of the Miami Fusion, a Major League Soccer team that closed its doors more than 10 years ago with millions of dollars in debt. While Miami's football record may be blemished, Team Beckham believe they can cash in on his celebrity and the rising popularity of the game. Nevertheless, some here think it's still a gamble.
It's going to be a slow burn or a slow fizz, depending on how the town reacts to the team. And whether Beckham's at the head of it or not, I think it's really going to be the product on the field and the stadium experience.
At the training grounds of Miami United, a local semi-professional team, there's excitement about the new franchise. But if you ask these players which teams they follow now, their answers are revealing.
Barcelona.
Barcelona.
Boca Juniors.
Liverpool, Real Madrid.
Paris Saint-Germain.
The teams in the US may not be as famous as those, but professional football continues to expand here. But ultimately, in Miami and beyond, it's the fans who'll decide. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Miami, Florida.